Okay. Let's play something different. Let's play a different game. This game is called Everlast. And forgive me, I'm gonna do a little stream maintenance to make this look good. And this game is, so what I wanted to do with the remaining time that we had was, play some stuff that I found on Itch. And I really love Itch in general. It really has the same feeling that I have about a lot of flash games and things like that. It's that the games are what I would call like enthusiast games. It's a lot of what I really love about a lot of the text adventures that I play as well. Like, they're games that are made by people who just want to make a game. And so this game is a FMV game that is no real actors. It's all AI. So it's an AI avatar. It's, I assume, AI words, AI speaking. So I find that really, really fascinating. And this game is by Nadyalev. On Itch. So let's play it. Cool. Let's not capture the cursor. So we have Everlast here. And let's play it. Live your best afterlife. Hello? Is anyone there?
If you can see me, it means that your consciousness has been at least 25% uploaded.
Where's the other 75% of me?
It's safely stored on a massive, distributed computing cluster owned by Everlast. Don't worry. The rest of you is uploading as we speak.
Am I dead?
If you're talking about your physical body, then yes. Your cognitive processes are no longer running on wetware, but we've modeled all your neural connections
wetware.
As bits of code that's currently running on silicon and metal.
Who are you?
I'm here to help you cross over. In ancient cultures, I might have been called a psychopomp. That's a little grandiose for my tastes. I like to think of myself as a combination of greeter, check-in clerk, and onboarding technician.
How did I die?
You were doing whippets inside a bouncy castle when you lost your balance and fell. The fall broke your neck, killing you instantly. Here at Everlast, you'll never sustain that kind of injury again, unless you're into that sort of thing, in which case you can simulate death and be reborn as many times as you wish.
The place we're in, it's so bare.
This is just the lobby. Once we sign you up for one of our digital afterlife membership plans, you'll have access to hundreds of worlds crafted for your enjoyment. Every aspect of your biology will be faithfully reproduced and infinitely customizable. You'll be able to taste every note in a glass of perfectly aged wine, while a hangover will be optional.
What kind of plans are available?
We offer three Afterlife membership tiers: Basic, Premium, and Elite. Your tier eligibility is based on your Afterlife participation readiness score.
My what score?
It's a trustworthiness score that determines what kinds of spaces you'll be able to enter and what kinds of privileges we can grant to your account. We can run the score in one of two ways: based on your past behavior in digital spaces, or based on your internet search history. Do you have a preference?
How do you have all this data?
One of the most wonderful things about your digital afterlife here at Everlast is that you'll always be surrounded with media that's tailored to your interests. Our goal is to make you feel seen. In building out this media-rich environment for you, we worked closely with several partners whose services you relied on heavily back when you were mortal. These partners can't wait to continue serving you here on the other side.
Use my online behavior.
Our records indicate that during the course of your lifetime, you made 3,201 internet shitposts, ignored 522 software updates, used your ex's Netflix password for 9 years, signed up for the same free trial using multiple email addresses on 18 occasions, and used an ad blocker on 82% of the sites you visited. Regrettably, these behaviors resulted in a score too low for acceptance into our premium and elite plans. It is therefore my pleasure to offer you our basic tier.
Doesn't everybody do these kinds of
things?
Your
attempt to justify your antisocial conduct towards our esteemed corporate partners by appealing to what you mistakenly perceive to be normal behavior has been duly noted. Your score has been further updated for future reference.
Alright. How basic is this basic tier?
The basic tier is subsidized by our corporate partners. Thanks to their generous contribution, we're able to offer you perpetual afterlife access free of charge. In exchange, we require that you submit to some minor adjustments to your psychographic profile, messaging settings, and emotional range.
My psychographic profile?
Yes. Already, at merely 25% uploaded, we're seeing some very strong patterns come through in your data that are taking up significant resource. In particular, your love for your mother, your first teacher, and your best friend. In order to run you cost-effectively on our basic tier, we're going to have to perform a search and replace function to swap your love for one of those people with love for one of our esteemed partners, Carl's Jr. Who shall we overwrite?
Stop. This is inhumane.
If you refuse to participate in the psychographic calibration, I am authorized to swap out all three of these people for three of our brands. Trust me, you don't want that. So please, make your choice.
Yeah, my first teacher.
I know that must have been a difficult choice.
It really
wasn't.
On
the plus side, Carl's Jr. is thrilled to have you as part of their family. To welcome you, they've transferred one Big Carl cheeseburger over to your inventory. Before we exit the psychographic calibration, we need to make another adjustment. It seems that your love for the remaining two people is taking up just a little bit too much storage space on the basic tier. I'm going to have to ask you to choose one more person whom we'll replace with another one of our valued partners, Lockheed Martin. Please make your selection.
My best friend.
Your psychographic preferences have been updated. You might experience a temporary feeling of having misplaced an important keepsake. Don't try to figure out what you've lost. That will only make the pain worse. Instead, think of all the wonderful ways that you can support the brands that matter to you. The more shareholder value your favorite brands create, the more they can invest in loving you back.
My messaging settings?
We offer our customers a channel to your loved ones who have not yet passed. Our basic customers are limited to 25 messages per month, 140 characters per message, and an overall vocabulary of 500 words to choose from. Messages must adhere to our code of conduct, which forbids sexual content, profanity, and negative assessments of Everlast. You may unlock new words you can use by endorsing our corporate partners in your messages. For every endorsement, 15 new words will be added to your vocabulary.
My emotional range?
While premium and elite members live on servers belonging to Everlast, our basic members will be running on the servers of corporate sponsors. In your case, that sponsor is Uber. Complex emotions are the most computationally expensive part of your model for them to run. For this reason, at times when Uber requires more computing resources, for example, during bad weather or rush hour, you may experience a temporary shutdown of your emotional faculties. During these periods, you may be assigned to assist Uber in route planning, vehicle operation, or customer service.
The basic plan is hell. Is there any way out of it?
You bet. We're here to empower all our customers in living their best afterlife by giving them the opportunity to earn credits that can be traded in for upgrades.
How do I earn credits?
In the past, there were quite a few jobs to choose from. Drone guidance, bot farming, content censorship, and DDoS swarming were some of the exciting and fulfilling roles we had to offer. It's been harder recently. We AI keep losing our jobs to living humans, but there just happens to be one opening in my department. Would you be interested in being a greeter, like me?
How long will it take before I can upgrade?
Let's see. You need 200,000 credits in order to upgrade to the premium plan, and earning that should take about 83 years. But don't worry, time works differently here. You'll see what I mean.
What does it entail?
It's sacred work. You get to usher people through a liminal space. You help them to make the right choices and to let go of what no longer serves them. And the best part is, you get to earn commission on their customer after lifetime value in perpetuity. And it's easy. All you have to do is read from a script.
I suppose I have no choice.
It's been a pleasure serving you. I look forward to seeing you around at the office. Your first customer will be joining you shortly. Goodbye.
What is this place?
You're in a massive distributed computing cluster.
Why can't I remember what happened?
Some types of cognitive processing, such as goal setting, attention, and impulse control, might be missing certain modules. But don't worry. You won't need those where you're going. And, like, this is part of what I enjoy about certain games, about, like, newer games like this that are made by one person. Sometimes they're a little buggy. Is that it? Is that all of the game? Let's exit. Play it one more time. Hello, is anyone there?
If you can see me, this is just... We offer three... It's a truck.
So what if we use our search history?
Our records indicate a troubling number of searches that suggest an unfriendly attitude towards our corporate partners. A representative sample is as follows. Photoshop free download. Home cooking meal plan. How do I block ads on my phone? Will I go to jail for credit card debt? Euphoria Season 2 Episode 7 Watch Online. Do I have to have health insurance? Is it illegal to steal towels from a hotel? And MacBook repair without Apple Care? Regrettably, these types of searches resulted in a score too low for acceptance into our premium and elite plans. It is therefore my pleasure to offer you our basic tier.
Okay.
The basic...
I can't live like this. Shut me down.
I won't be able to accommodate that request. It seems that you left quite a bit of debt behind when you died. When we uploaded you, we also purchased that debt. Your upload needs to stay up and running so that you can work on paying us back.
Interesting. Okay.
You bet. We're here.
What kind of jobs are available? I suppose I have no choice. It's been a pleasure. This is just the
lobby. Why can't I remember what happened?
Yeah, and I guess that's the end. Well, that's nifty. I don't know how much of a game it is. That's cool. Well, that was an interesting little game. I think the technology of the AI was super cool. And definitely, like, an option in games. I think that that maybe doesn't necessarily exist, like, for a given like situation. Like say you want to do a FMV game, but or have like one part of your game be FMV. I think it's a cool idea. So we're gonna do another FMV game, a different kind of FMV game. And this is by somebody who makes a lot of point and click kind of games. This is by Bad Lemon on Itch. This is The Cuckoo's Nest. I don't know a lot about it. It's sold as a 90s I think it's 2022. Might be a little earlier. Global Game Jam. Whatever that was. It says 19, so... Oh, 2019. Awesome. And let's add some sound. So let's play it.
Are you without a day, huh? How'd you wear it?
Hey, homie, it's me again. Glad you're here. I don't want to go home yet. Not after this day. I'm such a failure. Sorry, there was a timer on that. Who am I kidding? Let's just enjoy the drinks, man. What does he want? Vodka on the rocks, will ya? I feel depressed. Homie, enough about me, man. What is up with you? Here, hit me with the drink. Let's put that. Homie, I can't handle it anymore. I'm gonna blow my brains out. Nobody loves me. My kids, my wife, even you don't love me. Let's give him water. you say that. Oh, we don't have any of that. Oh, he's so sad. All right, he left. So looking at this, we have vodka, which amplifies your mood, not good for depression. Whiskey, the drink of the worker, good digestion. Wine is a soft and mellow drink, not suitable for big and dumb people. We have beer, a simple drink for simple men, can cause pain if mixed with a stronger drink. Pickles can cause cancer, poverty, and hangover, good for animals. And sparkle, which is shiny, expensive, and hot, really strong. Moonshine, which is a party drink for wild folks, can cause brain damage. And water, which is if someone had plenty of drinks, good old water is a good choice. And absinthe is almost a party drug, consumed with care. Let's call the resupply. So we have $16. Let's get one sparkle, one moonshine, one water, two vodka, two water. And like, what I wanted to do with this was showcase like what people are doing with Mishala Urbam Kebab Ya Sam Urbap Yunak, me from far, far away. Haltium drink, sparkly, sparkly. Hey, you got sparkle. Tashakira Rhythm Effendi. I don't know what that means. What if I give you wine? You don't like it. Did you not give me anything back? Well, okay. That's not great. Yeah, this buddy. And like, I think this is an interesting... Can you believe this guy? Phil's such a loser. Unlike me. Aren't you being rude, Joe? Who are you to talk to me like that? Don't you know who I am? I don't. Hey man, hit me with a bourbon. Oh me, I know I've been harsh to you, man, but it's the damn government that made me that way. Kelsey pieces of shit. We have to respect each other. Do you respect me, homie? Give me a drink. Wait a sec, I need to do something. Okay. And like, I think it's interesting what people pick up on from like the FMV world. Blah, blah. Oh, he's gonna piss on my bar. Great. I have four. Whiskey. Good enough. Arr, long ago, no see human, very thirsty, want something wild and special. Here you go. No? Oh, yeah, you drank it. Much thank you. Do you want more? Here, have a beer. Oh. So like, this is obviously like not a fully realized game. Yeah, what's up? Hey, Omi, best guy in the world. You know this place is like home to me, man. And it's not just because I don't have a home. Hey, do you happen to have some spare change? Yes. All right, man, I promise you, it's for holy causes. Hey, homie, give me a bottle of beer, please. But can you put it on my tab? Yeah, here. Ah, man, I'm gonna kiss you like a topless mangusta. I don't know what that means, but it's definitely interesting, like, what people pick up on with FMV. Like, these short looping animations as, like, the thing that this author picked up on, I think is interesting and definitely, like, worth looking at as, like, a aesthetic. I'm also curious, so this is as far as I got. Oh, I have a mouse now. Hey, homie, it's me again. Glad you're here. I don't want to go home yet. Not after this day. I'm such a failure. Can you believe what my wife told me today? Yeah, why not? Here, have a pickle. You gonna pay me, bro? I don't have any. Oh, I do have vodka. So that's Phil. So I'm wondering what, like, the full gameplay of this is. Or is it just looping at this point? I think it's just looping. Come on, Papa Joe. Actually, yeah, I'll think about it. Yeah, I guess you're right. So everybody drinks beer in this, like, as their animation. It kind of bums me out. I wish they did a little bit more with the animations. At least had, like it wouldn't be that much more. Who was that? Give me a drink. Yeah, I wish too that, like, they talked about, like, oh, like, these things do certain things. And, like, I felt that way about Valhalla, that, like, cyberpunk, barista simulator, where, like, there was a lot of storyline behind, like, what the drinks actually did, and that it didn't actually do anything. If this loops one more time, then we can take a look at another game. Wait, he came back. Why is he back? Come on, Papa Joe. Everyone has the right to drink. Well, I don't have anything other than water. So let me give him water and see what happens. No. That's not a whiskey, man. It's good for your health. Trust me. Good, get out of here. So at least that got a different, like, thing to do. What's this guy again? I don't have anything. You get water. It's a little rude of you, homie. Jesus, at least tell me you're busy. I don't have anything to give you, buddy. Oh well. You just gonna leave? Well, see you around. So, I mean, this is definitely like a basic prototype of a game. At least I redid it. I'm gonna give whoever comes in next. Yeah, you get absinthe. Sure, break it to me. All right, who am I kidding? Let's just enjoy the drinks, man. He's so sad. I don't know what I did. He didn't even pay. But I'm not seeing any new content, to be fair. Yeah, I'm not seeing any new content. This is interesting. What happens if you let the timer run out? Yeah, the silent treatment, huh? Yeah, I might have said too much, but that skunk is gonna get it someday. Hey man, hit me with bourbon. No, that I don't have any. Okay. Well, that was interesting. There's one more game that I think uses FMV in an interesting way, and it's called Kodachrome. I also don't know when this was released. But I really like these kinds of games because, like, why did you go down there? Whoa there, buddy. What's going on here? Boo-doop. Boo-doop. Doing this live in the moment. Especially since it's not 2019, it's just, I am not sure. Okay, so this game is a photo-taking simulator. So there's three photos that we need to get. We need to get a kickflipper. And that's at 85 millimeters. A mines meeting. That's at 52 millimeters. And hazard, which is at 24 millimeters. And plus and minus change the lens. Enter advances the film. And the carrots revert, fast forward, play. Double tap to restart. All right. So, can't move anything. This is what's going on in the scene. And since this is silent, let's get some tunes going. So, this is what's going on in the scene. We have a bunch of stuff. We have kickflips. We have some people. We have a warning on the wall. So, okay. The first one that we need, kick flipper, is at 85 millimeters. And we can move around this a little bit. There we go. Okay. So that's definitely the kick flipper. It says hazard 24 millimeters. So we need to find a hazard at this range. What's that? Skating without a helmet. So, everybody's skating without a helmet. Okay. And then, oh, whoops. Set at 52 millimeters, we need to find mines meeting. So it lights up if you get the photo. You have kick flipper. We figured out there's a kick flipper. And so, like, I think this is a really fascinating use of FMV. Like, it's almost like looking for So, like, we had three radically different kinds of FMV with these games. We had one game where it's kind of like a lot of modern FMV games. So that Everlast was like a choose-your-own-adventure. Here's the video, and you get different videos based on what you answer. I think in particular Everlast was interesting because its subject was an AI avatar. The second game that we played, the Cuckoo's Nest, I think was actively trying for a retro feel, and they called it like a 90s bar simulator. And with the looping characters and kind of almost less FMV and more like digital capture, like Mortal Kombat or something like that, was what it was like. And then this is like trying to find a like specific gameplay mechanic out of it being video. And I think that's interesting. No, I thought that was a person, but it's not. And, like, I think, I don't know, I'm interested in, like, how one might rethink, rethink how you play games based on FMVs. I think that's one of the things that holds back FMV games, like, from the vintage era, is that there's not that feeling of, like, the FMV is adding something here. It's tacking on FMV to a separate game, and that's interesting, but I think it's also flawed in that FMV is a totally different medium. It's video. How do you approach video in a way that, like, makes that medium interesting? So I don't know if I'm going to be able to beat this, but I do want to at least finish it off. I've got three more pictures. I'm curious what happens. And it's like, what is a meeting of the minds? If it's not that. And then there's Hazard. And then thanks for playing, and that's it. Well, that's, again, interesting. I think those are three interesting FMV games that are new. I think they're all very early and more prototypes than full games. I think that's okay, though, to be totally honest. But that was definitely interesting. I don't know. I'm not trying to, change the way that people think about it, but I do really think that that's like worth, I don't know, checking out. And like, it's always good to check out what's coming out and what people are doing on like the periphery of game development. Like, I don't think that there's gonna be like a triple A title with full motion video again, you know. And so is the answer, oh, you know, let's never look at full motion video again? Or is it, well, who's actually doing full motion video now? So I just wanted to take a quick look. I think when we do have like an hour left on stream, something like that, you know, we'll do more and more of that, both for Text Adventure Tuesday and for FMV Friday. We will be back on Monday with more, yes, more Nethergate Resurrection. We are getting really close to the end of that, though. Maybe one or two more streams. I'm really stoked about that. And then the next week for Text Adventure Tuesday is more Choice of Magics. And then the next FMV Friday, I will get with JRAM and find out what we should take a look at. So that sounds really, really fun. I hope y'all come out for any, all, whichever of those streams sound really, really cool. Definitely, we love any time that you come out. I'm going to be posting some stuff to the YouTube, and you can always find like slimmed down versions of these streams, cut apart for games and things like that, on the channel under the highlights tab. So definitely, thank you so much for coming out, and thank you so much for you know, having a good Friday with us. I hope the rest of your weekend's really, really good.